following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out there, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for
That's awesome.
For a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. To begin a great relationship, know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are and what the needs of your mind are and what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women. Some of them will make good match for you and others won't. The two of you only need to be like a key to lock, a match that works. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 31. NASDAQ is up 40. S&P's up 1. Gold contract up $4.80 trading at $12.79 an ounce. Silver down 7 cents, $15.30 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 57 cents, $53.19 a barrel. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year note up 10 ticks, 121.23. 30-year bond up 23 ticks, 145.22. And King dollar up 503 ticks, 96.275. The euro is at 113.02 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 109.66. And the pound is at 130.56 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, we get over to the SPY, folks. We take a look at this. You got an inside day. You've had a high out here of 264. You got a low of 262. You're down 3 pennies, and you've done anemic volume, 43 million shares. So bottom line, it's still game to get up and into the high that was established last Friday, which was the 266.98. NDX 100, we take a look at the 3Qs. What do you have with the 3Qs? 3Qs actually are pushing a little bit further, up 86 cents. Now, the Qs are going to need some volume coming into this close out here because you have divergence. We're at 27 million right now. We'll see if they can do 37 million. That'd be quite a bit to get done. The 163.44. Yeah, look at this, interesting too. So this is still an inside day in the queues also. We haven't got over that high yet. Small caps, we go take a look at the small caps out here. Small caps basically are pushing higher. You've done 13 million shares, and that also is an inside day. So right across the market, we do have an inside day. Some of the higher volume equities in out here, and this will be a low volume market. The chip stocks are what basically is keeping the NASDAQ higher. We have Advanced Micro up $1.16. You have Micro Technology up 272. You have, Xilinx. Xilinx is a new all-time high, monster volume, by the way, up $16.43. You got Applied Material up $3.42. That's quite a cool move on Applied Materials. We go over and we take a look at Applied Materials. You're going to see that it's taking out a B point, taking it out with volume. These are all ABC structures on the way up. So if we look at Applied Materials, your A point on this is approximately 29. Your B is like a 36. You're talking $7. You're talking about 40 bucks. And I suspect that it could actually run to 42, because 42 is the last time that we had big volume on the way down, 42.66. Lam Research, LRCX, you see this thing. Now, what's intriguing here with Lam is this, is that Lam's up 21 bucks, but watch this. If I'm going to bring Lam all the way back, and you can see the type of retracement that it did, it was a vicious retracement, okay? And Lamb was one of the first ones. Well, first off, Lamb was one of the strongest equities before it just extended itself and got absolutely smoked. Okay, so the first high in Lamb Research was November of 2017. And then what it did, it came down with volume. The first high was established at $219. The next week, it was at $180. Yeah, down $39. 3 weeks later, it got to a high of $218. 2 weeks after that, it got to a low of $156. Vicious, right? You know, you're talking about a $70 move. And guess what? 7 weeks later, it went to a new all-time high and imploded. $234, and then we went straight down to 4 weeks ago to $122. That $122 number, folks, was coming against the strength that took it up from April of 2017, rather. So what do you have now? Bottom line, this is wide price spread, huge volume. This thing wants higher price. And when you do take a look at the aspect of the full move, percentage-wise, what we did in the Lamb Research, from the lows that were established in 2016 to the highs that were established in 2017, bottom line, did a 0.618 retracement. You know, so when you do a 0.618 retracement, it's saying, okay, you're not going to take out the highs, but guess what? The way Lamb is set up and the way these rest of the semis are set up, it looks like they do want higher price, and we're going to see those babies moving, which will give some juice to the NASDAQ composite as well as the NDX 100. If we take a look at the composite right now, is up $43. That also looks to me like it wants to go after the highs of last week. The highs of last week, a 71.84. Big numbers. Now, King Dollar, this is going to be a big number for the metals market tomorrow, because what we have with King Dollar is that volatility was pretty amazing out here. King Dollar first off went higher this morning, then just about gave the whole deal up. Okay, so let's just take a look at this. So your first high, picture this. So your first high on King Dollar this morning at 8:30 was 96.295. Then King Dollar went straight down to 10 o'clock to 95.810. And guess what? From that point on, then it made a higher high. When all said and done, no matter which way you look at this, King Dollar was pushing with volume. What we actually have here is an ABC structure up. Your A point is a 94.635. So you get about 1,500, which would get you 96.70, 97, and the high is 97.195. Yeah, this is going to get intriguing because this wants to go after its high. So your price projection is in the 97s, and the last high that was generated out here is 97.195. We've done 33,000 contracts, so big volume all over the place, and it would be, of course, as I just said a little bit earlier, as to it's amazing that gold is only down $5, and King Dollar is up half a penny or 509 ticks with volume. Stay right there, folks. We come right back to recap out here. We get the Dow right now down 19. NASDAQ is up 42. S&P is up 2. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 22. You get the Nasdaq up 43. S&Ps are up by 2.5. Let's go over and we take a look at Intel. So Intel is going to be coming out with their numbers after the closeout here today. They are up $2.08 right now. They are going to be looking for revenue of $19 billion, and they're looking for earnings per share of $1.22. Not bad. $19 billion in 90 days, right, folks? So what do we have here? Intel, you got an ABC structure up. This is going to be pretty wild. So your A point on this is 43.51. Your B is 49. So they're talking about, what, $4.50? And your C is, so that's 52. And 52 would be a price projection. Yeah, that's saying that these babies, these semis want to go. That's going to be pretty wild watching this thing shake out, man. I mean, we know from Lam Research last night in Xilinx, folks. Lam and Xilinx, they came out, bottom line, came out with decent numbers. They're going topside in a big way. If we go look at Xilinx, XLNX, this is pretty amazing, actually. Particularly because we just had a downdraft, but you can see looking at this stock, even in this stock, the downdraft, well, last high that was established was in December at $95, December 3rd. It went down into December 24th to 79. So, you know, it's down $15, then just took off again. And this takeoff topside is pretty dramatic. You get, yeah, an ABC here gets you, let's say, 69. It's almost like $26, which is going to get you, oh, look at that's, this is just, this is, now, the way that Xilinx is set up is that this just finished an ABC up right where it is right now. But this type of bar, folks, okay, when you get this type of acceleration up, that type of bar, most times you're going to, basically, you don't have to necessarily get another one that looks like it, but you're going to go higher before you start backing down. We go take a look at Micron Tech. That's the same way. This is another ABC structure up. Micron is up 275. That's taken out the 3673. That sets up 28.5. So let's say ballparking at $6. That's 3860. And right now we're at 37. So that one's almost done. Now, If we go over to the S&P, what's intriguing about that, you know, yesterday, the day before, I started talking about this aspect that it almost looks like that this market is setting up a small ABC structure up in the SPY, in the S&P itself. And if that's what you get, your price projection is going to be the lows of October 11th. And that's that was the first leg down. What that also is, folks, is that that is the 0.618 retracement of the whole move from the highs of December, highs of October to the lows of December. And that would be a great move just to get the bulls and the bears going. You know, because the bulls would get going in a huge way. The bears would be saying, oh, no, I can't believe it went up that high. Bottom line, that's where the trigger probably is going to be pulled. And, you know, we'll see how the rest of these numbers start coming out even after the close today. Next week, you get a monster week coming on. You get Amazon. Amazon's the 31st. Amazon is up $7.90 right now. That's still in a consolidation. You get Google. I think that's either the 4th or the 31st. That's the 4th. You get Facebook. That's the 30th. Microsoft. Oh, we just had Microsoft. No, it's the 30th. Microsoft's the 30th also. So the 30th is going to be a big day. And the way Microsoft is trading here, Microsoft very well could be an ABC structure up too. That's how this baby also is trading. Silver, let's go take a look. Oh, actually, I want to go take a look at the oil market. Because what did happen, folks, we got these oil numbers out. And these oil numbers were a monster. The drawdown was a monster, but oil hasn't really done much. Oil's up 1.2%. Yeah, this is saying quite a bit. Let's just see what happened here, because the drawdown was pretty dramatic. Let me get these back. 11 o'clock this morning. Okay, so you had, oh, I see, it was a build. Interesting. Now it was a build. So the estimate was a 750,000 barrel drawdown, but you got a build of 7.9 million barrels. Man, that's lucky oil can be up at all at that number. That's pretty amazing, actually. That's quite a build. We get lots of oil. Natural gas, we also got those numbers this morning. Natural gas is, this market natural gas, folks, you talk about it moving around. When we got the numbers out this morning, let's see. Yeah, so numbers were coming out, natural gas at 312, it gets down to 305, and right now you're trading at 313. And you only have 88,000 contracts. Yeah, that's not enough volume on natural gas to sustain higher price. When we look around the globe, last night what you had, folks, is that you had Asia was trading higher. You have Europe was higher today, was slightly higher. If we go over, let's go take a look at the pound first. So we had that vote last week at Brexit. That's when the pound shot down to 126 and then took off like a rocket ship. So we're at 130. This looks to me 132 is game inside of that. The euro hasn't had much movement. Bottom line is that the euro is going to need a lot more movement. Let's see. Okay, so the euro is down 75 ticks, 113.05. Oh, yeah, that's why the dollar's up so high, too. Euro's breaking down. Let's see this again. Yeah, that's quite a breakdown. And if we pull this back, yeah, euro's going to go after its lows of 112. 112.16. That's a big number, and that's, I suspect, that's what's definitely pulled that baby back. So let's see. Draghi was talking out there today, claiming he was dragging down banks. Bottom line is that he was dragging down the euro. Whatever he was saying out there, that was putting selling pressure inside the euro. And, of course, the euro is 60% of the dollar index, so that's how you have that high volatility inside the dollar, and that's why the dollar also gave it up, because the euro, well, that's why the dollar went higher as the euro was giving it up. If we go take a look at the yen, what you're going to see at the yen, this is continued to be a sideways move. Yeah, the yen's been 4 days, actually 5 days sideways. Right now, it's up four ticks. You're trading at 109. And let me just go look at the Shanghai market, because it's like the chicken or the egg, the Nikkei 225, rather, versus Shanghai. So the Nikkei right now, that was down 19 bucks. So that was a sideways move last night. Yeah. The Nikkei set up like the S&P. The differential is, yeah, it is set up like S&P. So that's saying that the yen can still get weaker. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial, so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technician's Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to the TLT. I'll stay with this bond for a few minutes. So, yeah, this is intriguing. Okay, so the TLT right now is up 3 million shares. Now, that's not enough. You know, we're going forward, but that's not even close. Let me go look at the 30-year. You know, each day, what has been happening, folks, is that we're getting some pretty good divergence in the markets. And what we have out here today is you have divergence between the note and bond market, really moving topside. And, you know, it's not like our market's basically a down. You know, you get the NASDAQ, I mean, the S&P's down, what, 2 points. You get the Dow up, and you get the Dow down and the composite up. You know, right now the S&P is actually flat. So that being said, though, you know, the note and bond market, this is still moving. You get 275,000 contracts. That's saying it still wants to move at a higher price. So there's divergence there. And the divergence would be that when the note and bond market, you know, bottom line, continues to want higher price, that is saying that, you know, the longer aspect is inside these S&Ps is that they want lower price. You know, that being said, what we have here is that you're going into the end of the month, you're going into window dressing, and you're going into a huge amount of earnings coming out, and you're coming out with the big dogs. Let's go look at PG&E. So check this out. And don't buy this stock, folks. I can't wait to see how this one plays out. Okay, so this is what you have here. PG&E, this baby already is... it's up like $6. It closed yesterday at $7.99. Bottom line, it's been trading $14.75, and it just halted again. This is what's halting PG&E is the rules for the aspect of how far an equity can move before a halt. And what you have here is this: they're cleared of the 2017 wildfires that took out wine country. And what you had out here is this: California investigators have determined that a private electrical system, not equipment owned by PG&E, caused the second most destructive wildfire in state history, which broke out in wine country in 2017. The report findings come as PG&E prepares to file bankruptcy as early as next week because of the $30 billion worth of potential liability stemming from 2017 and 2018 fires. The Tubbs Fire, which swept through Northern California in October 2017, eventually destroyed thousands of homes and killed 22 people. California investigators have already named PG&E equipment as the ignition source of 17 of the 2017 fires, while alleging violations of state law. PG&E has said its fire safety programs have met the state's high standards and that it has taken a number of steps to reduce risk. Bottom line is that you get it up $6.19. I don't think that's going to stop them from still declaring bankruptcy on the 29th, folks, because they already gave, that's the 2017 fires. The bottom line is that now we're dealing with the 2018 fires, and the 2018 fires were much bigger than the 2017 fires. So, you know, it's pretty amazing how things can move around, but you know what that is? You know, and we'll see. I suspect what you're going to see is that the day they do file, you'll see that baby go all the way right back down. There's another great story here about this, actually. And what this is, and don't let this fool you either. Okay, so watch this. This morning out here, you had, let's see, I'll find the story. You have a fund that, here it is. Okay, so you have Blue Mountain Capital Management, they basically are saying that they want to replace all PG&E's board members at the annual company shareholders, and they urge the utility not to take action on its bankruptcy plans. Well, you know why, folks? Because what ended up happening, unfortunately, for Blue Mountain Capital Management is that they bought, here, let me get you the number of shares they bought. This is pretty intense, actually. Okay. Let's give me 1 second here. We'll find this number of shares because, okay, here it is. Blue Mountain bought approximately 4 million shares in the third quarter before the stock plunged. So here, let's just pull this up. Okay, this is pretty sick. Actually, PHDC, let me see what they own first. So you got Blue Mountain. Yeah, I don't even see them on here. 1 second, let's see. Blue, oh, there it is right there, yeah. So what you're gonna see here, this is sad. So they own 4.3 million, but they bought 95% of them. Yes, they probably already own 300,000 in the third quarter. So if we bring this back before it plunged, so you're talking about they bought at $47. Can you imagine? $4 million shares at $47. Bottom line is, of course, they're going to fight this thing. They're going to fight it tooth and nail. It's not going to do anything. This company only has a market cap. It has a market cap of $7 billion, and it takes in, the gross revenue is only $17 billion. And anyway, we'll see where the whole thing comes down. My take is that what you're going to see here is that they still are going to go BK, and they're going to start over as they did. They went BK, 17 years ago. They started over again, and I've seen this plenty of times. They'll just wrap the clock again, start the clock again, and more than likely what they'll try to do this time is basically get some of those laws on their side. Because right now the laws are not on their side. I brought this up last week, actually. If they want electricity in the middle of the desert, folks, which California is, the bottom line is they got to put something else in place to safeguard the utility companies to deliver utilities. Because bottom line is that, yeah, electricity, guess what? It gets all fired up, man, in a big way. And you can imagine how fired up it can get when you are actually in the middle of a desert, even though it's nice and green, because guess what? That's what you have in California, in a lot of California. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the XAU, the HUI, inside the metals market. Both of them are going sideways. If we take a look at how we traded out here yesterday, yeah, not enough volume yesterday. XAU, you did 23 million, come off the low of 34. We're going to need a lot more volume. Tomorrow is going to be, I suspect, a nice, highly volatile day inside this metal market, because this dollar has action. We have Europe have an action. We have our government still shut down. They're trying to straighten that out as we're doing this program right now. We'll see if they can come to a deal just to get the door open, get some of these people paid. Dow right now, down 43, NASDAQ up 38, S&P's flat. Come right back.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We go take a look at Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac. So Fannie Mae out here, the low for the last 12 months, folks, is 98 cents. The high is 296. And if we take a look at this right now, you're going to see this. You get movement out here. We just went from a price point of 247, you're at 283. And what's going on there is that you get Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac quickly surged to session highs after Politico tweeted that the White House will announce a plan by next month to end government control of Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, in a bid to resolve long debate over the fate of the two companies that dominate the mortgage market. This is going to get interesting to see how this does shake out, because what you have had is that you have a couple large players that basically were putting their money on this for a long period of time. Let me just see. FMCC. FMCC. So, largest owners. Let me do this. That's Freddie Mac, PHDC. Yeah, interesting. So it's the same. It's Capital Group Companies. So it looks like you have Capital Group Companies. They own 52 million shares, 1% of Fannie Mae, and they own 2.6% of Freddie Mac. Let me just see where this one is. Parkland LLC, Cleveland, Ohio, same groups. I believe this is a hedge fund group. I just drill down. And then there's another one. This one's in California. But bottom line is that it's going to be interesting to see how this shakes out, because, you know, this has been going on here. If I bring this back, first let me bring it back just 10 years. Yeah, if I bring it back 10 years, you're going to see this is trading at 27 cents forever, then spiked to $6.35 in 2014. By 2016, it's back down to 98 cents, does one more spike up to $5 in 2016. That being said, though, this looks like yeah, it looks like that they could get some action once again, you know. So the real question is going to be is that how are they going to get it back into private hands, you know? Oh, so here's the article right here. Okay, cool. Let's see what they say. Okay, so let me put that up for you. Okay, so here's the tweet. The White House will announce a plan by next month to end government control of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac in a bid to resolve the long debate over the fate of the two companies that dominate the mortgage market. The real question is going to be, what do they do about the aspect of how this will work. You know, because what you definitely had, you know, they went broke, but then what they did, folks, is that on the housing rebound, they made more money than they ever made. The differential is that the amount of those dividends, though, got confiscated by the government. So I believe there's still court cases that are going on right now as to the confiscation of those dividends. You know, bottom line is that, yeah, the government has power, but guess what? You're supposed to still follow the rules inside that power structure. And we'll see whether they followed the rules or did not follow the rules. Apple, let's go take a look at Apple. Bottom line is that Apple's still having a tough time. It's really subtle out here today with Apple, but what you have is this. You're down 175, and this looks to me that you're going to go right after the 145 once again. And they are coming out with their numbers on the 29th. So they're coming out next week. And this one here is a little problem child. This has been a one-way route down the last 4 months, from 233 to 152. And there's not much stopping this thing to get down, you know, into this 134. 134 would bring it into a lower range. You know, that's because when you take a look at Apple, Apple was actually pretty amazing. Because the last time that we actually had any volume on Apple goes back to like 2012. You know, after that point, after $92, this thing just kept going up on air. But guess what? It did. And then, of course, it only took 3 months to go down from $206 down to $146. Big numbers. The semiconductors out here, that is what's leading the NASDAQ. That's what's leading the NDX 100. And we are going to have Intel after the close out here today. So we'll see if Intel will perform. It looks like it's going to be an ABC structure on the way up. We go take a look at the Walmart, the retailers out here. So Walmart right now, So Walmart, a lot of these equities, folks, are acting just like the actual indices. Walmart today went down to $96.43, rejected lower price. That's saying it's going to go after the highs of yesterday, once again tomorrow. And because of the way these setups are, this also can be an ABC structure on the way up. Because what has happened is this. We came off that low in December, and this has been a straight line move off that low. And straight line moves with back downs. So the straight line move, if you get just some type of volume, then you pull back and you get light volume, that's a setup for an ABC structure on the way up. Because what ends up happening is very easy to take out the B point of that type of structure, because in the first case, as you were going up, bottom line is that you went up and you were going up on light volume. Then what ends up happening is that you pull back with light volume, but guess what? It's lighter than you're going up on, so that's still volume on the way up. Then trying to take out the B point is much easier because the volume at the B point's not a lot, but that still constitutes an ABC structure on the way up. XLF, let's go take a look at the banking sector out here. So you get rates that, bottom line, don't want to go up, they want to go down. And you can see this in the banking structure. Now, this is a differential. The XLF right now, no juice whatsoever behind it. You know, it has that high from last Friday, decent juice. That being said, this here is a different setup than the SPY. Let's go take a look at JP Morgan. And you get JP Morgan, yeah, same thing. Sideways moving JP Morgan. And if you want to see how a market bottom line, let me see if I can find this article, how a market just basically just forgets things like real quickly. Well, you got all these bankers over in Davos, and you know, they basically, you have Saudi Arabia having huge billboards all over the place, and the bottom line, guess what, 3 months later, after the bottom line, the murder of the journalist, and guess what? They're all right next to the Saudis right now, wanting to do business. So it took all of 90 days for all of them to basically sit right down again and dial up to the table. So much for the banks, the banking structure. Dow Industrials right now down 48, NASDAQ up 39, S&P's up one. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Great moments are born from great opportunity. And that's what we have here, folks. The opportunity of a lifetime for most. I'm Steve Rhodes, the 2018 Market Timer of the Year. And on Thursday, January 24th at 4:15 p.m., I'll share with you what I see as the next great buying opportunity. This free workshop, sponsored by NinjaTrader, is available to everyone. There's no gimmicks, no credit cards, no lengthy sign-up, and you don't have to be a subscriber to my award-winning daily newsletter service, Mastering Probability. All you need is a name, email address, and contact number. Just click on my name on the homepage of TFNN.com to gain access to the live or archived version of the next great buying opportunity. Folks, everything in life happens for us, not to us. The fact is, this workshop is happening for you so that you can learn how, why, and when to take advantage of the next great buying opportunity. Timing is everything. So sign up today on the homepage of TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow Industrials up 43, NASDAQ down 30, S&P's up 1.5. And, you know, we were talking about Apple a little bit earlier, folks. And so with Apple, you know, we get self-driving cars, the whole bottom line hitting Fast and Furious. Well, Apple's not going to be involved in this first part of it, that's for sure, because what they did do this morning is that they laid off 200 people from Project Titan. And that was their basically plan to build an autonomous car. And it's probably smart getting out of it before a mess really develops, because what you have out here is you got let's go to Tesla for a second. Tesla, no doubt, is the leader. Bottom line, that's the leader out there. But what you do have right behind them is every major manufacturer, whether it's GM, whether it's Mercedes. Bottom line, you know, they're all out there. They're right behind them. You know, Tesla still, though, this Tesla's in just a large consolidation. That's how this is set up. And last time we were up at that high of 387. It has volume up there. So this thing's not done yet. You can see a Tesla itself has pulled back into strength from the week of October 26th. So bottom line is that, yeah, they're going to have challenges. That's for sure. Next time they're coming out with numbers is going to be on the 30th of January. So we are going to have some big numbers next week in a huge way. After the close out here today, we also got some big numbers. If we do go take a look at the S&Ps, bottom line, you get a sideways move. Sideways move, light volume, doesn't say much. Coming into a Friday, the biggest, I would say, piece of information out here is that this good old dollar wants higher price. And so we'll see if that's more than likely what this is about is that the euro is going to break down. The euro today went from 113.91 to 112.90. That's a full penny. That's a big number move. It's going after the swing area here is 112.16. You break that, you can really go a lot lower because this has been a consolidation that has been in place since November 16th. Stay right there, folks. Come back with some numbers. Dow Industrials down 19. NASDAQ is up 46. S&P's up 3.5. We'll come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish down 21. NASDAQ was up 47. S&P's up 2.5. You had an inside day out there, folks, and you had light volume. We take a look at the volume inside the NYSE. You came in with volume of, they're still kicking it in, but right now it says 600 million. It's going to be more than 600 million. Inside the NASDAQ composite, we are at 2.3 billion. So the composite did have some volume. Now, what gets interesting there is that, you know, the next 4 or 5 minutes, we'll get more volume that's kicking in there. So that would be saying also, you can see with the composite, it's pushing slightly higher and you're kicking in with some volume. We go take a look at the NDX 100. NDX 100, we did light volume, 31 million contracts in the queues. It's not a lot of contract volume, no doubt about that. What was pushing the equities inside the NDX 100 as well as the NASDAQ composite today with the SMHs, folks. Semiconductors, and this is an ABC structure on the way up. If you take a look at the SMHs, you got an A point out here that's laying out at approximately 82.5. It's about $11, which gets you a price projection of just about $100, and right now you're at 95.06. Gold contract. Now, tomorrow, coming into tomorrow, is going to be a big number for the gold contract. Gold is down to $3.80. Not the end of the world, and not much, actually, for how much the dollar was up. 12.80. If we go take a look at this contract, what you're going to see is that, bottom line, you know, it got down to a price point of 12.75. That was established out here at 8 o'clock this morning, 8:40. Rejected that price. Has 219,000 contracts. Now, so the way gold set up is saying, hey, that's saying it still wants higher price. That being said, we, you know, when we take a look at the dollar index, what you're going to see with the dollar index is that this baby had high volatility. In fact, they just sold it off again into the close. But bottom line is that you did 33,000 contracts. You took out these swing areas. That's saying that the dollar index once again wants to go for its highs. And that has to do with the euro. The euro is breaking down, folks. That euro today went down pretty fast and furious from 113.91 to 112.90, full penny. Stay right there, folks. Lots of numbers coming out after the close. We are in the thick of earnings season. Dow Industrials closed down 22, NASDAQ up 47, S&P's flat. We'll come right back.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot range from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful day. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take it by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy tomo! I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you going to do right now? Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finished down 22, NASDAQ up 47, S&P's down 3. NASDAQ, folks, as well as the NDX 100, it was all the chip stocks that kept them higher. Gold contract down $4.10, trading at $12.79 an ounce. Silver, $15.32 an ounce, that was down 6 pennies. Light sweet crude, up 55 cents. $53.17. Now, it's pretty amazing that the light sweet crude bottom line was up at all, because what you had is that they were expecting a small drawdown, and they got basically a plus of over 6 million barrels coming in. Notes and bonds continue to want higher price, lower yield. We had the 10-year note up 11 ticks, 121.27. 121.23, rather. 30-year bond up 25, 145.24. Both had volume on the way up. King dollar, this is about the most volatile I've seen King dollar in a long period of time. Up 453 ticks, trading 96.225. The euro is at 113.09. That is breaking down. The yen is at 109.59. That's going sideways. And the pound is at 130.62. That is breaking topside. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. Now, in the world of the S&Ps, bottom line, all the indices out here today, folks, did have an inside day. They still want higher price. The high that was generated out last Friday, that's where this baby wants to go. The real question is going to be, does it take that high out with volume, and all of a sudden you get an ABC structure on the way up that will bring you up into the lows of October 11th. And that the October 11th number, folks, is two different things inside the major indices. It's the 0.618 retracement from the highs that were generated out here in October to the lows in December. Also the last time that we had monster volume on the way down. But the way this market is setting up, that's where it looks like it's going to go, because you have the amount of numbers there coming out, and on top of that, you have window dressing coming out, and that could just give it enough juice to get up and into that area. If you do go look at take a look at the SMHs, you're going to see that the SMHs are in an ABC structure on the way up. SMHs today were up $5.23, blowing away the swing point of $93.32. We blew that away with 12 million versus 8 million. So, bottom line, that is on the way to higher price. Gold contract, this is going to get really interesting coming into a Friday with a gold contract. So, Fridays in the metals market, folks, can always be pretty intense. The reason being is that gold stops trading inside the pit at 1:30 Eastern Standard Time. Does not open again until approximately 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, and that's when Australia opens. Bottom line, what we did out here today is that we did reject lower price. You know, we went to 1275. Bottom line, rejected it. You're at 1280. And so just a normal being at 1280 saying, hey, man, that's going to go for the highs once again. Now, that being said, we get over to King Dollar, and you look at King Dollar, and this is where it gets pretty intense. Because what King Dollar has done is that King Dollar is up almost a half a penny. You got 33,000 contracts traded. So you took out a B point with volume, and that's saying that King Dollar can get right up into the highs that were generated out here on December 14th, at 97,195. It's gonna be a wild night out here. If we go over to the Euro, you're gonna see where the breakdown came inside the Euro. Draghi was talking out here and inside the European Union out here today, and as the more that he talked, the more that the Euro, he started out talking approximately their time, 5 or 6 o'clock in the afternoon, our time, 10 o'clock in the morning. The euro goes from 113.81 down to 112.90. Big move. And there's not much below this where the bottom line, the euro can go. The euro, the low in the euro in the last 6 months is 112.16. And it looks to me like 112.16 is going to be game inside of this market. That's how this baby is laying out right now. Numbers. Let's go take a look at a few numbers that are coming out. So you had all the semis today go topside with volume. Now what you're going to have is Intel's going to ruin the party on the rest of the semis. Intel closed at $49.76. That is trading right now at $46.22. So it was up $1.82 today. It's given up $3.40 right now. And let's see what they have to say. I believe they missed the gross number also. So revenue, they expected $73 billion. They did $71.5 billion. Decent miss. Earnings per share, they expected to do... Earnings per share, they expected to do $1.02. They did 87 cents. Big numbers. There's no doubt that that is one big number. As they're going forward, the estimate in the first quarter, they had a range of $16.37 billion to $18 billion. They brought that range down to $16 to $17.34. Big number there, no doubt about it. The gross margin, oh my God, what a business this is. Gross margin, folks, is still running at 61.7%. The estimate has been 62%. Imagine taking a gross margin of every dollar you take in, 61%. Sense of it is profit. That's quite a business. Pretty amazing, actually. Let's see. Intuitive Surgical closed at $536. This is trading at $530. That's nothing for Intuitive Surgical. This stock normally likes to move $20 or $30 on earnings announcements, but let's see what they have to do. So they missed, but guess what? It must be a small miss. Their revenue is $1.05 billion. Their growth is 19%. The earnings adjustment, the estimate had been, $3.04, and they come in with $2.96. So Starbucks, S-B-U-X. Let's go take a look at Starbucks out here. Starbucks closed at a price point of $64.74. That is trading right now at 67.10. So let's get a little juice in it. Let's see what that's doing. Yeah, it's had high volatility out here today, too. Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back with more numbers. Recap out here. Indice-wise, you have the Dow down 22, NASDAQ up 47, S&P's flat. We're coming right back. We'll be right back.
folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. SBUX. Let's go take a look at what Starbucks has to say. So Starbucks out here closed at 60. Well, the low for the year is at $47. The high 68. So you're laying right next to it. We're trading. We closed at $64.74. You're trading right now at 66.27. So let's see what they have to say. Their comps are up 4%. It's a big number. Earnings per share estimate had been 65 cents. They made 75. Decent number, no doubt about it. Let's see if we get this breakdown. Okay, so here we go. Net revenue, let's see, fourth quarter. Okay. Okay, so revenue, the estimate had been $6.49 billion, they turned 6.6. So decent number there. Their operating margin is 17.4%. Not bad for a coffee company. That's, with the amount of help they have, that's pretty intense, actually. Their comp sales are up 4%. The estimate had been 3.3. That's a decent estimate also. China in the Pacific sales, they that estimate is almost double. It's only up 3%, but they're only expecting 1.5%. Emerging market, that's a plus 2%. America, operating margin is much better than normal. So their full operating margin is 17.4%. In America, it is 22%. In China, they're only operating at an 18% operating margin. And then in the emerging markets, they're at 10%. Oh, interesting. So, and the first quarter, they opened 807 new stores in the Americas. So that's going to be South America as well as North America. They're reiterating that year-over-year growth, they think they can still grow by 5 to 7%. So that's a big number, man. Let me just go look at this chart. So we're trading $67 right now. Starbucks had some big volatility today. It went down to $62. We pulled this back. Look at that, right back to us. Yeah, that's right. We did this before. Starbucks is probably an ABC structure up. Yeah, that's what you get. Your 8-point on this. $35 approximately. Yeah, you get $29 A to B, which is going to get you $76. $76 would be your price projection on a monthly ABC structure on the way up. And that's what it looks like it wants to do. So that's going to be a decent number. It's pretty amazing too that you. Well, as long as they grow in China, I guess the bottom line is that they can keep growing. We go back to 2015. They took in $19.5 billion. This 2019, they plan on taking in $26 billion. Bring it to the bottom line, $1.58 in 2015, $2.65 in this year. And revenue is still mostly generated out of the South America and North America. $16.7 billion. Out of that $26 billion is in the Americas. 4.5 is in China. About 3.3 is in emerging markets as well as other markets that they're just starting to develop. We go take a look at Bank of America, BAC. Actually, let's look at Berkshire Hathaway, BRK, because what we have out here, this is going to get interesting to see how this shakes out. Yeah, Berkshire still can't get any juice. Berkshire is coming out with their numbers, no, not for a while, February 25th. But this looks to me like you're going to go to the bottom of the consolidation again. The bottom of the consolidation on Berkshire Hathaway runs down there into the 186 area. One of the equities that took off in a big way out here today, folks, and don't touch this equity, bottom line, it says PG&E. This baby, when you look at it, you're going to say, what are you talking about? Don't touch it. This thing was a rocket ship, and it was a rocket ship. Okay, this is the equity. Bottom line, they're going to file for bankruptcy. Well, we'll see whether they do it, but bottom line, file for bankruptcy. As of the 29th of this month, they had to give the state of California 15 days notice. The stock had gone from $49.42 in November 7th, all the way down to a price point of $5.07. Now, what did happen out here today, which had the stock take off from $7.30 to $14.50, was the fact that you had the PCG. We had the state of California clear them in the... Okay, so California just cleared the giant utility PG&E as the ignition source of the deadliest 2017 fires that ravaged the wine country. Now, that being said, they cleared them of ignition source. Now, watch this, though, folks. This is where this gets really wild. That's the first part, but then what you have is this. So when we take a look at this, there's a lot more fires than 2017. 2018 was, in fact, the biggest fire. But there, so the headline news kind of goes like that, right? The news as the aspect of what's going on with PG&E is not like that, though, because this is what you have, is that the Tubbs fire, which the PG&E was cleared of accounting of starting it, was 60% of the roughly $17 billion in liabilities that they thought they had. That being said, what you have out here is this, is that doesn't include the 2018 fires, as well as it doesn't include, now this is the kicker, right? they are still on the hook for 17 of the 2017 fires that fire officials have identified its equipment as the cause of those fires, and they are still going as far as saying that the investigations, that they could be criminal violations in 11 of those blazes. So bottom line, you know, this is going to be a long story laying out, but I suspect what you're going to see out here is that you're still going to see PG&E go BK. There's another story out here this morning that you had Blue Crest management basically going after PG&E, saying that they think the whole board should go, they think they shouldn't go bankrupt. Well, what you have with Blue Crest management, folks, unfortunately, is that what they did is that they bought PG&E at the highs of 49, and they bought 4 million shares right before, literally right before this thing, well, about a month before it basically went south. So you can imagine you're down from a price point of $50 on 40 million shares, and all of a sudden, 2 months later, you're down at $5. Big, big number. Monster number, actually. So you can expect that this fight's going to go on. I expect what we're going to see is that, number one, it's going bankrupt, and we're going to see that basically come in next week. Futures out here today, whether you take a look at the S&P futures, the NASDAQ futures, the Russell futures, each one of them, folks, had a sideways move. This market still wants higher price. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial, so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube.
TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at Western Digital. So Western Digital out here, folks, the low for the year is $38. The high is $106. We are trading $40 right now. Well, we closed at $40. You're trading $38.45. Western Digital, let's see what they have to say. So revenue, the estimate had been $4.25 billion. They came in at $4.2 billion. Earnings per share, $1.50. They came in with $1.45. Not that bad. Bottom line is that this has been quite a downtrend, though. Yeah, holy cow, you're talking about a one-way. Man, what a trend this is. Look at this. This is amazing, folks. March of 2018, it's at $106, and this thing only took one breather. So you went from $106 in March down to $75 May 4th. You did one bounce to $88. And then you went straight down to 53, went sideways to 57, then went straight down again to 42, and then straight down again to 33. That's about as intense as you can get. That is a monster number. There's no two ways about that. That is, let me pull this back a little bit more. Okay, so yeah, this is a monster consolidation. This is already back, pitch 2017 levels. Yeah, this is pretty amazing, actually. This is back to 2008 levels. That's where we are on WDC. Now, this is always a highly volatile stock. This is almost like a commodity stock. All chips are kind of like commodities. Let's go to Rich in Oregon. Hey, Rich, what's going on?
Tom, thanks for taking my call.
Sure.
You're in the area of the chips. And I'm calling about microchip technology.
Okay, so let's take a look at it. It was up $4 today, up 5%. The low is $60. The high is $104. Let's see what's happened to this after hours. Nothing. That's good. They are coming.
Now they report next week in February.
Okay.
Well, not next week. The week after.
February 4th, yeah. So it looks like you're going to have an ABC up. I like it. You know, you got, okay, 78.72. Let's see, 78.50, 79. Yeah, you got a confirmed ABC up. So what happened is this. It went to a price point today of 79.58. You had to take out 78.72 with more than 4.5 million. You did 5 million. So your A point on this is $66. Your B is 78. I'm just ballparking this, so just do it yourself so you get that exact number, all right? It's $12.
Okay.
73, 83, 85 bucks. Let me just see this. Yeah, it's not bad. 85 is your A to B equals C to D. Now, what's pretty cool here, Rich, and this I've been looking at a lot of these, and this is how a lot of these actually are setting up. That's the last time that we came down with big volume also. If you happen to be watching Tiger TV, you can see on August 10th, that volume sticks out like a sore thumb. And that's what does happen on bounces. You know, what happens, folks, is that what you'll see is that everything gets extended, you know, because that's how the markets like to do. They extend on the way up, they extend on the way back. So I think you get a little setup here, man. That's what it looks like.
Well, if it does reach the 85 area and it's not on increasing volume, would you sell it out?
Yes. I would do anyway, most of the time, I sell out ABC structures on the way up or the way down because they always seem to do something different. And they can do a very large retracement after that, you know? So it.
And this one looks like it's got a history of doing that.
It does. And what happens is this, folks, if you understand the ABC structures, it's not the end of the world. Because you've made a good profit, whether you know you're going short the equity or long the equity, and I don't have the exact percentage, but it's pretty intense that they do. Like if we have doing an ABC structure up, it hits this structure, it might go a little bit further, and then you get the pullback. So you always have another chance of getting into it. If it's going down and you're doing ABC down, you shot the stock, the exact same thing happens, you know? Because you can pitch it, you know, that's hard to do. I mean, these ABC structures, yeah. You know, they're not easy to do because what ends up happening, particularly, this is a good one. That's a large point ABC structure on the way up. Now, what's really cool about how this is set up is that what you have two different things happening now. Intel's come out with their numbers, right? And this isn't getting hit after hours, which is good. Now, I suspect tomorrow morning will get hit a little. And if it doesn't get hit, then you know you get something that's even stronger. You know, because okay. Intel, let me just make sure Intel's still down. Intel closed at 49.76. Yeah, it's trading 46.27, you know, so that's a decent indication that it's strong. And, you know, maybe they're in a different part of the whole chip business, but the bottom line is that Lam Research, Xilinx took off, AMAT took off like a rocket ship. AMAT is something you want to watch, folks. The reason being, what happens is this, is that most of the time, AMAT's down from a high of $62. We hit a low last month of 28. Now, what happens is that AMAT, if these chip companies are making money and they need more warehouses, more equipment, more basically factories, AMAT is going to be the first one to know about it. And if you, let's see when they're coming out with the numbers. They're coming out the 13th. What you're going to want to watch inside AMAT is that what is their backlog? Because what happens, folks, is that when they're building chip factories, they have to order this AMAT equipment literally 2 years ahead of where they're projecting where they're going to go. And you can see AMAT's numbers are pretty amazing. They did $9.7 billion in 2015. This year, they're expecting to do $15.6 billion. They're still growing in the Asia-Pacific market by 25%. Now, the reason that would say that is that that's where all the chip factories are. That's the bottom line, but... You get action, man.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Tom.
Okay, man. You have a great one, man. Have a safe one. What was intriguing out here today, folks, is this. So, picture. You still have the S&P. We had a sideways move in the S&P. You're coming into the end of the month. You're coming in next week. As we come into next week and the week after, folks, you are talking monster numbers coming out. You're talking all the big dogs coming out. This market is going to be basically, the volatility is not going to slow down this market. What you have out here is that the volatility is, it wasn't volatile today inside the S&P. Inside the currency markets, they were highly volatile. Commodities, not that much. What I do expect is that this market is going to continue to be volatile. And here's the wild card. The wild card is going to come down. If we take a look at this S&P, I suspect the wild card is going to come down to the point of, like right now, you get senators, Congress, they're trying to get a deal done, bottom line, opening the government. But what I expect, what you're going to see, you know, it doesn't look like one's going to get done today. But one's going to get done one of these days, folks, okay? The government's not going to be closed forever. Bottom line, I suspect when that gets done, that market will get that nice pop. It's just a perception, but the way the market is set up, the market looks like it wants to do an ABC structure up into that low of October 11th. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523.
The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Great moments are born from great opportunity. And that's what we have here, folks. The opportunity of a lifetime for most. I'm Steve Rhodes, the 2018 Market Timer of the Year. And on Thursday, January 24th at 4:15 p.m., I'll share with you what I see as the next great buying opportunity. This free workshop, sponsored by NinjaTrader, is available to everyone. There's no gimmicks, no credit cards, no lengthy sign-up. And you don't have to be a subscriber to my award-winning daily newsletter service, Mastering Probability. All you need is a name, email address, and contact number. Just click on my name on the homepage of TFNN.com to gain access to the live or archived version of the next great buying opportunity. Folks, everything in life happens for us, not to us. The fact is, this workshop is happening for you so that you can learn how, why, and when to take advantage of the next great buying opportunity. Timing is everything. So sign up today on the homepage of TFNN.com.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's take a look at this. So you got ResMed, okay, who happens, they develop manufacture market metal equipment for sleep disorders. The low for the year is $87. The high is $118. This closed at $117, and this is trading right now at $110. And let's see what they have to say. Okay, so their year-over-year revenue growth, they're increased by 8%. Margin is 58.9%. Operating profit increased by 8%. That all being said and done, bottom line, folks, is that this baby is down by about $7 right now. So market doesn't like what they're saying out here. The biggest number out here today, folks, is Intel. When I was just talking to Rich in Oregon, we were talking about the chip business in general. So what had happened, Intel came out with numbers today. Intel closed at $49.76. That's trading right now at $46.40. Now, their numbers were light. That being said, when you take a look at Intel, this Intel still wants higher price. So I can't wait to see how Intel trades tomorrow morning. This is why. What Intel did out here today is this. Intel did volume of 48 million. Your last high out here had 30 million. You took out a swing point that had 29 million. So you have a confirmed ABC structure on the way up. So check it out. You're down 46 cents. That is going to basically bring it, let's see, to $46. Yeah, it's still only going to bring it halfway down. You probably have a complex ABC structure on the way up. So Intel is something you want to keep your eye on tomorrow because your A point on this is 43.54. Your B is 49. 43, yeah. So pitch almost $6. That's saying that Intel could do 53. And if you have a gap down, I'd be just deviant enough, right? Yeah, you're at 46. You have a gap down, bottom line is that put a stop under that gap and you're looking for that ABC structure on the way up. That's how you'd be trading that. Overnight tonight, we take a look at the Asian markets. What you have is this. Asia out here last night was basically flat. I don't know, flat to higher. It looks to me like you're going to have basically a higher market out here tonight. If we go take a look at the Hang Seng first, Hang Seng was up $1.12, $112, 27.20. Yeah, see, this what's going to be cool here, too, at Hang Seng, too, is this, folks. This is set up just like our S&Ps. This also looks like it wants an ABC structure on the way up. This is going to, so keep an eye on Asia tonight. Because if that, we're very, really close to the top of this B point, which is 27,323. We're at 27,120. If this takes it out tonight and you have volume behind the move, that brings your probability much higher that no matter what the volatility is in our markets, meaning that the volatility in our markets, you get these S&Ps that are basically fluctuating by 10 to 20 points every day, like nothing. Today was actually a slow day, because if we take a look at the S&Ps, once you start getting used to 20-point moves, you're going to think, as one of our tigresses said in the den, that this is a boring day. Well, the thing that's amazing is that the S&P did move from 26.47 down to 26.26, but because you get used to higher moves, then that is a boring day. you gotta love it, because I remember this so well. When each and every time we get volatility, real volatility, and then all of a sudden it starts slacking off, it's like, oh, no, please don't do that. Because what happens, folks, volatility is actually a trader's best friend. You just have to basically, you know, make sure that you're not in a one-way market. And, you know, we've been in a one-way market for a long period of time. What a one-way market is that just a trending market, whether it's trending up or trending down. When you get a two-way market, what you're doing is that you're basically looking at swing points, you're looking at the Fib numbers, you know, and basically taking your shots and taking your money off the table, putting it back on the table, taking it off the table, putting it back on the table, because you do have a two-way market. And you'd be really surprised on a two-way market just how much you can pile up some profits intraday, because you can see, well, we just see today, you know, you had the S&P down at 9 o'clock this morning was at 26.30. By 10 o'clock, it was up 17 points. By 11, it was down another 10. By 12, it was up 9. Now watch this one, it was up 9. And then you went down from a price point of, yeah, it went down 18 S&P points until 12, and then you went back up another 15 S&P points coming into the close. So you can see you don't have to catch all of those. You want to catch the middle of those moves. You get the middle of those moves, you are basically off to the races. What's going to get interesting out here in the Venezuela market is where these bonds are going to go and where the oil market's going to go. You know, you're getting a big showdown down here. We have a government showdown here. They have literally a government showdown there in a much larger way. What is happening, though, is that the bottom line is that it is moving their bonds around. It's moving their currencies around. And what is going on now, though, is that kind of the Pompey's kind of in a box here. And what the box is the aspect that we've recognized the new, no, well, he is new, he's head of the assembly versus the dictator they have out there as new president. Simultaneously, they're thinking of putting more restrictions on Venezuela, but the bottom line is that if, in fact, we do that, then we're basically jamming the same person we just said is the president right now, so there's a lot of movement in there. That being said, what has happened in the financial market is that their currency has been going higher by 25% last 2 days. The bonds basically have gone higher also, meaning the payback. And we'll see where this shakes out. You know, I think they're close to getting rid of this dude, man. And it'll be really interesting that, you know, the thing that's amazing is that I remember when this first started, and you're going back all the way to 1994, folks. 1994, there's plenty of people that unfortunately had to leave Venezuela. And if you don't remember Venezuela then, Venezuela was not only a first world country, it was a first world country. It was very rich, very educated, all of the above in a huge way. And then, bottom line, you had Chavez come in. He took it south for years. The next guy came in, bottom line, pure dictator. But what you can see, and this is what's really important, you can see how a small amount of people can control a huge crowd for long periods of time. It's a big heads up. Make sure that you understand that, okay? Because if you don't understand that and you don't take responsibility for your own actions to live freely, it's a big number. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. So coming into Friday, folks, currency markets, bottom line, this dollar looks like it's going to want a higher price. Euro crashed lower today, not crashed, but bottom line, went down with conviction. That's why you saw that dollar go topside. You're going to get some action out here tonight. There's no doubt the Euro's in never land right now. So we'll see whether it can stop at this 112.16. Draghi start talking out here today. Euro goes from a price point of 113.91 to 112.90. Market-wise, folks, what I expect you're going to see out here, this market still wants higher price. Now, that's in the short term. The bottom line, on the long term, we're still going back to these lows that were established in December. On the short term, however, I think we're going inside the S&P up until this 279.36 in the SPY. If you're taking a look at the cash S&P, which is a great way of doing it, because the bottom line is that cash S&P, it's the same date. It's October 11th that you want to keep your eye on. That'd be 2710. That'd be quite a move from where we are. We're only at 2642. So you're talking about 80 points. So, and 80 points, of course, in the Dow Industrials actually end up being 800 points approximately. So the Dow Industrials, I suspect, can get up until 24,899. So call it, 24,900. So that's another 450 points. No, 350 points inside the Dow Industrials. The composite, if we take a look at the composite, and the composite is going to be absolutely something to keep your eye on because it's still the strongest indice. And on the composite, we're talking about 72.74. So that's 200 points on the composite. And it's going to be all about how we attack the highs of last week. The highs of last week, they look to me that they want to get attacked. What we did do out here today is that you had the chip stocks do that ABC structure on the way up. Intel come out with numbers after the close, but Intel is a confirmed ABC up. So it's going to be intriguing. It's going to open down $3 tomorrow. We'll see whether it holds. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. We look forward to speaking to you right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Wow, go get them, folks.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.